Hi guys, so welcome again to my channel. In this video, I will discuss why stiffener and doubler plate are used in any beam column junction when this is a moment connection. Okay, so nowadays you may know that steel structure is very common because compared to your concrete construction, steel structure requires less time, and also this is compared to concrete construction in Western countries, this is economical also. Okay. So, whenever you see any portal erection like this, you may observe that this junction, this is a moment connection. And in this junction, you can see that a stiffener has been used. And also, in addition to this stiffener, in some cases, a doubler plate here is used. Okay. So, in this video, you will learn why this stiffener as well as this doubler plate is required in any moment connection. By the way, if you are new to this channel, please do subscribe because you are definitely going to be benefited. Okay, so without wasting time, let's start. So in any moment connection detailing, you may see that continuity, or you can say stiffener, the stiffener has been used, and also it is mentioned that doubler plate as required. Okay, so first learn why this continuity or this stiffener is required in moment connection. Okay, and then I will discuss why doubler is also required. So by the way, the doubler plate looks like this. Here you can see this is a column section, which is I section or white flank section. Okay, and here you can see that this blue colored plate is known as doubler plate, which is simply welded with your web part of this column. And here you can see this is the stiffener, okay, or the continuity, also known as continuity. So in this case, you can see both stiffener as well as doubler plate has been used. This is your doubler plate. Okay, so why this is so, let's discuss. First, this is a general arrangement for beam column junction, and here this is moment connection. Okay, and when this moment connection is used, in case if the beam is fixed ended or built up beam, or maybe this is a continuous beam like this. Okay, in those cases, in both the cases, what happen if you apply load at the support, there is some moment. So the bending moment diagram looks like this. Okay, so from here, let's say in this beam, there is a moment. It may be clockwise, okay, or anticlockwise. It doesn't matter. For the right now, let's say this is clockwise. Okay, and you know that in beam, especially in I section or white flange section, what happened? The bending moment simply converted into a push and pull, okay, or tension and compression. Simply, if the bending moment is M and this depth between the center of these two flanges is D, what is the value of T or C? Simply M by D. Okay, so it is clear that due to this support moment M, here a compressive force C, and here a tensile load T is being applied. Also, the vice versa is applicable if this moment is anticlockwise. Okay, so at this point, we are getting a compressive load. Okay, and if you simply look into the cross section of this column, we can see that this is the compressive load C, this is the point, and in cross section, it looks like this. Okay, this is the column section, and this is the C. So here the load is being applied, C, or you can say this is nothing but equivalent to a fixed end column. Okay, a fixed end column which is subjected to a compressive load, and due to this compressive load, simply this try to buckle. Okay, so to resist this buckling, if the radius of gyration are about this axis or about this axis is less, in that case, what will happen? this web will buckle. To resist this buckling, what we have to do, you have to simply increase this radius of gyration. And the best way to increase this radius of gyration is to put this stiffener. If we put the stiffener, let's say this is the eye section and we are putting the stiffener only in one side. Okay, here. This is the stiffener. Obviously, in this case, the R is small compared to this R. And even if this R1 is not sufficient, in that case, we'll put another stiffener at this side also. Okay, so if you now apply a load, suddenly compared to this one, this is more stable. Here the wave is more stable under buckling action. Okay, so that's why in this picture here you can see that this stiffener has been used like this. Maybe in this side also there is another stiffener. Okay, so now it is clear to you why stiffener are used in this moment connection. Now it's time why this doublet plate is required. Okay, so let's find out. Again, consider this picture. So due to this moment, there is a tension here and compression here. Okay, or we can say that compressive force is acting here. Okay, and also the tensile force is acting here. Okay, now if I redraw this zone here, you can see that this is a force acting like this and this is a force acting like this. So this is nothing but a sheared force. Okay, so if this is a block, you know, this is simply bed, frictional bed, and if you apply a lateral load like this, what will happen? This body or this block is under the action of shear. The same thing happens here. Okay, if you consider this as fixed, so this tensile force is creating a sheared zone in this area. Okay, also the same is applicable if there is a moment here in this beam and there is a push and pull here. So due to this push and pull, a sheared is also operated here. The similar thing also happen when there is a moment in column. Okay, due to this column and moment, there is also some push and pull, and due to this push pull, maybe there is some shear action like this. Okay, so this whole zone, which is known as panel zone, is under the action of a shear force. Okay, like this. Okay, the direction may be based on your moment, but for the timing, consider this is the shear stress acting on this panel zone. Okay, and this is nothing but the wave part of this column. So here you can draw the resultant force. So the resultant force looks like this or act like this. This is tension, and here this is compression, this is compression. Okay, so in this zone there is a resultant compressive force as well as a resultant tensile force. Definitely due to this resultant compressive force, again this zone try to buckle. Okay, or you can also visualize like that when there is shear force here, or let's say shear force is acting like this. Okay, and this is your panel zone. So definitely this particular cross section, when you look, it is something like this. This is the eye section, this is the wave part. Okay, and this shear force must be carried through this wave part. Now if this wave is not that much thick, or thickness of wave is less, in that case definitely it is going to fail. So what you need to do, you need to add some extra plate here. Okay, like this. Also in this space, if at one side it is not sufficient, now the thickness of the wave is more, and definitely it will resist this buckling effect as well as it will carry this shear force. Okay, so this is the reason you provide the doubler plate here. Here you can see, to increase the thickness of this wave, we have provided this doubler plate. Okay, here this is the doubler plate. So that's all. Thanks for watching.